Sorry again, I have like my school backpack on and my school armor and my slippers.
Thank you, everybody. I'm Jason. I play a little guitar and write songs. And so it's perfectly fitting that I'm here tonight. Right, Dana? Songwriter night. It was nice to be invited. Ben Baldwin set this up, invited me to come down. And this is something new for me. I've done band stuff for many years with a band called The Nines. And once in a while, I'll play a solo tune somewhere, but never have I tried to fill 45 minutes. And so, forgive any bumps and bruises tonight. I promise. I'll try to make us all part friends with a smile on our face. This is one I wrote with one of my songwriting partners in the Nines, Mitch Town. One of the first songs we wrote back in, in my folks' basement. Is where, well, where any decent band starts is in their parents' basement. And I promise I didn't live with my folks until I was 40. The band is just that old. It's a song about, it's kind of a breakup song. It's a breakup song where only one party is actually broken up about it. She's got a job out of town, and she's going to a far, far, far away place. A magical place called Calumet City, Illinois. And he knows she wants him to be upset. she wants him to be upset, so he has to pretend like he's upset while still encouraging her to go, because that's what he really wants. Confused yet? Okay, so am I. This is Calumet.
You've been talking about leaving for too many days. You ever been to Calumet? I think you should go. I think you should. See you when I get there, and you know you can trust me. I think you should go, and I think you should go. No, it ain't Chicago, but it's better.
Night, but I think for these things, it's kind of fair to once in a while sprinkle in songs from songwriters that the songwriter loves. And I think probably, I don't know, the artist that's had the most impact on me as a listener, as a musician, songwriter, is Prince. And I'd say probably pound for pound, you know, as a multi-instrumentalist, as a performer, as a writer, certainly among the top pop forces of the 20th century. And we've all heard the Little Red Corvettes, the Purple Rains, the Let's Go Crazies, but he has just a multitude of songs that really never hit the radio that were just really beautiful. And there's one he wrote when he had first met a woman he was to marry in the early 90s, and she was probably 20 years his junior, and he kind of anticipated some backlash on this, so he wrote a song that kind of praises her, yet kind of braces her, I think, for what was to come. It's called Morning Papers.
He realized that she was new to love, naive in every way. Schoolboy's fantasy she was. That's why he had to wait. If he poured his heart into a glass and offered it like wine, she could drink and he make a wish on every wave. Take a bite of camera cellulite, or kiss in every cave. Make a contemplate the entire universe on just one star. Tell me just how far was a walk for the morning paper.
In attendance tonight. If you haven't met Courtney, Courtney, raise your hand. So before I ever knew the woman, I knew the voice. You may remember, she had for many years a gig on local radio, before that in Chicago, and she was on a pretty good signal here for some time, and I remember hearing her in the morning and thinking, wow, you know, I actually would like to meet her. And it so happened we had a mutual friend. And I would always listen really intently, not only because my friend would call in and kind of do bits with them, but I could listen to her talk. And one of the things you learn when you're on radio is if you have a good station, advertisers want to use your voice when you're doing their ads. They want your voice associated with the stuff they're selling. One of our clients was a Toyota dealership, and I just distinctly remember, as part of the context of the commercial, her saying Solara. I was like, wow, it just rolled off the lips. And next thing you know, my band was playing on her show, and here we are. So I'll give this one to her. I gave it to her actually as, I think it was an anniversary present, a few years out from our marriage, as just kind of a recount of events. It's called Say Solara.
We never did much talking. You were only mine to hear. Now we're talking all the time. Say Solara, yeah, don't be shy. I heard you say it on the air. So say it for me here. Say it one time, a little rip. Let the words roll off your lips. Say Solara. Drive. don't be shy. I heard you say it on the air. Now say it for me here. Say it one time, get a rip. Let the words roll off your lips. Spectrum, I kind of felt it needed more balance on the good girl side, so I took it upon myself to do that. I don't want my girl doing things I can get the other girls to do. I don't want my girl doing things I can get the other girls to do.
power you hold. When it comes down to one word, one simple, simple word. That word is no. Take credit for, but thank you.
freezes up from time to time.
Thank you. Tender little tune by Delamitri. That's drop B tuning, Dan, in case you're wondering.
There we go.
So if you don't have much,
if you're not in love right now and you don't really have much use for love songs,
what is love?
People don't hurt me. Dude, I'll sing it if you dance to it.
Oh, I'm there. I've been dancing to it all night.
That's John, everybody. He's coming up here in a little bit. We got, is Gage here yet? Gage? I think he's the other guy on the bill. I haven't met him yet, but looking forward to it. Thanks again for the Down Under for hosting something like this. Not a lot of spots do this kind of thing on a Thursday night, so I do appreciate the opportunity. Back to love songs and how useless they are to some folks. Now, you guys are in love, engaged in fact, so this isn't for you, but there are those that just aren't there. And this is who I wrote this one for, not you. Okay. What's up next? Okay. I'll watch for it. So a lot of singer-songwriter types are, they seem to be influenced early in life by, country music or something rootsy, more rootsy kind of music. I never had country music in the house when I was growing up. I had Motown and polkas. It was pretty much all I remember from my childhood. So I discovered country music little later on. I had the good fortune of touring with a local act, and so that kind of exposed me hard and fast to what country music was. And this was in kind of the early 90s, mid-90s, when they were having that re-explosion of country, when it was almost rock shows. I mean, you had guys like Garth Brooks swinging from the rafters, and you're thinking, okay, is this country? Well, it's you know, they're good songs, and where's the country in it? And one artist I always kind of fell back on as I was learning these cover tunes and listening was George Strait. He was just always really solid, had good songs. He was, you know, not swinging from the rafters, just kind of resting on the tunes he had and just his kind of very basic delivery. And so he kind of caught my ear early on, and one song of his that I always really liked was, it's called The Chair. And it's really just a kind of a creative pickup line in the form of a song. And if you listen to the words, you'll kind of get it. I'm assuming all of you get folks know the term coming out party. Agree with that? So when you discover at a certain point you're maybe not who everybody thinks you are or wants you to be, and you want to announce it. which is totally cool. You throw a big bash and everybody learns at once, and it's kind of a bonding experience. That's totally cool, but not so cool when you're dating that girl. True story. It's called Coming Out Party. Here's a $10 I owe ya. You don't have to pay me back. I'm going out quiet, baby. That girl is fine, fine. You done good. You really did it this time. And not like everybody thought you would. Sound brother, thank you very much.
I'm gonna close with one. It's got a few years on it. So I go to my
5-year class reunion back in 1999. And I run into this girl that I always had this thing for in high school, right? And it's always a girl that dates guys 2 years older. They're football players, they're baseball players. They got nice, expensive cars that are just unattainable, right? So I run into this gal at this reunion, and I'm thinking, you know what? 5 years have passed. I'm working at Homer's, living with my parents, but I'm in a band. So this song is, it's basically my case to a girl that probably didn't want to hear it. Well, I'm the only rock star you know.
My friend, I want to know me, friend. Not if you come around anymore, but it's always nice to hear your voice. But if it takes all night, I'm gonna keep singing, and you'll be loved. months of getting back into you and talking to the people that we both know. Our silly games still come a dime a dozen, but I love you more than I did years ago. I've been someone so beautiful, not far in love with me.